Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to my world, this is The World Away, and this has been a long time coming, hasn't it? We've got issue 30 of the Hero Collector and Eagle Moss release of Build the Ecto-1 from Ghostbusters. Now this is going to be covering stages 111 to 114, and the first half of this is going to be a complete mirror of what we've actually already done, just making the wing section at the back of the vehicle here. But we are going to be doing the fender, putting the number plate on, and some of the skirting as well. Let me show you what we've got to do. As you can see, we're going to be creating the wing section there pretty much over the next two, like we did in the previous pack here. The only time this differs is once it's gone on the vehicle, which we're putting it onto the vehicle there, we do have a wheel arch to put in, and then in the final piece here, we've got some skirting to put in for the vehicle as well, including the rear fender with the number plate there. We do, in this one, check this out, finally get to attach the steering wheel. I know a lot of people are asking me about that. Now, if you want to get this for yourself, I'll put the link in the video description so you can get this all the way from pack one. Now, I'm aware at the moment there are loads and loads of modifications for this out at the time. I've got a few of them here, which I'm going to quickly show you, but I will do a standalone show for this because there are so many. But this is just some of the things that I've grabbed. We've got the blueprint, which I keep behind me on all the builds I do. We've also got the name plaque looking like that, which again are through partworkupgrades.com. And then Mike Lane has been in a complete frenzy where we've actually got some metal gurney floor rails so we can replace the ones in the vehicle there. We've got rear seat back covers for the jump seat there. We've got wheel caps. If you never need to take the wheel caps or you've damaged your hub caps, these are magnetic and they can just push on. These are brilliant. We've got die cast license plates, which as you can see, they're there. But I mean, check out Mike Lane's site. He has got tons of stuff, but I will showcase this and we'll get these onto the Ecto-1 as well. But because I haven't had a delivery for a while, I haven't really been able to show you this, but I wanted to show you what's actually out there in the community. But we're gonna jump straight onto this because we haven't done it for a while. So without further ado, let's get cracking. So it's all going to start with stage 111. As you can see, these are all the parts here, so I'll get these all out. So the first thing I'm going to need is the light housing looking like that. And this is going to go onto this piece here, just into the middle slot here. Now, it can only go in one way, so if you just rotate it, that's how it's going to go. It's going to be held in from the other side with an AP screw. So there you go, putting that all the way in there until it's nice and tight. There we go, that's in place. We've then got this thin piece of trim here. We're going to be putting this along the bottom edge, making sure it's round the right way so it matches the indents that we've got on the bottom edge here. So we're going to have one here, one this side, and one at the end, like that. We're going to be securing that down with EP screws. So one in the middle, one on the end over here, and finally, one just at this end over here. We've got another trim panel just to put over this section. I do love all this chrome. This chrome is plastic, but it does bling, as you can see that there. That's just going to go in here, and once again secured in from the other side with EP screws. I think EP screws being the choice of screws in this stage of the build. So that's one. And number two will be going through that side. So that now looks like that. Now we do have another piece of trim, which I'll get out and show you. And that eventually is going to go across this lip at the top here. We don't actually secure this in this stage. So that's looking like that. And we also have this piece here, which we're going to save for a later stage, because that's all there is to do in this stage. So in stage 112, we're going to be doing the left rear reflector and the out of light here. So we're going to need this massive case that you can see here. And we're going to be dropping a reflector in there. Now this is what the reflector looks like. It's all red and that's just going to fit into there so it fits nice and flat. Then we're going to be putting a cover on, which will reflect the light. That's just going to go over the top. So I'm going to drop that in just like that. And that's going to be held in with AP screws. I know it's been a while since we last did an Ecto-1, but you do have to have that deja vu feeling because obviously we did this on the other side there. But it's good to be getting back on with it, I have to say. By the time this is done, the car is pretty much going to be what it's looking like in the iconic film. The only things really we've got to do are all the roof stuff and the gurney rails inside the gurney bed. But there we go, that's in like that. And then the only other thing we've got to do is just put a reflector just into the front here. This is a lot smaller. And that looks like this. It has got a grill section, but it can only go in one way because of the way that the screws are laid out in it. So it's going to go in like that. That's going to be held in with some really tiny RP screws. And there you go. Lovely and secure. That's one whole unit now. I can keep that to one side because we have got another little light in here that looks like that. It's more of a lens. And that's just going to go on top of the housing that we put in the last stage. We just get to push that in. So that looks like that. And that is all there is to do in that stage. Now in stage 113, everything's gonna start coming together, which means I'm gonna need to get the vehicle down as well. So we'll get to that stage in a second. Let's put this to one side. And the first thing we need is this other bit of trim looking just like this. And just like we did last time, we have got a lens housing to put on here. That looks just like this. And again, it has got a keyhole pattern so we know what way round this is going to go. This is just going to go in like that. Held in once again with an AP screw. So I'll hold it with my finger. And I'll get that in. We're going to put a lens just over the top of that. Just like last time. So push in. Make sure that goes all the way down. So it's nice and flush. And then we're going to be putting the electrics in here. Okay, you will see I've taken the car off the shelf now because I need this lead. This lead is Q because this has got the lights on for the rear brake lights there. So we want to take the very end light here and we're going to be pushing that into the hole on this section here. Sort of like at a 90 degree angle this is going to go in. So I think personally it's going to be easier to actually take this whole unit out, which we just put in. I wish I remembered this from last time. Just like that, and then plug that in while it's out. Now what I do is, because I want that lens to go in all the way but I don't want to break it, I am just going to put a little bit of oil just around the edge there, and that's going to slot in like a glove. And I'm also going to use some flat nose of my flathead screwdriver to just help push that down, so that goes all the way in, holds itself, no chance of that coming out at all. I'll put that back on the vehicle here. And there you go, when that's on, it should look like that. And we have got the first light in there, no problems at all. Bring across the part that we've just worked on here, because the next light, in a similar fashion, is gonna go into the one underneath here. So this time, gonna bend that down. Again, I'm just gonna apply some oil just to the fitting round here, just so that lens can just slip in there, no problems at all. And I'll get that in here. Put it in gently, get my flathead screwdriver, and then just push that down. And there we go, that's gone all the way in as well. Then we've got this bit of trim section here. Before we bite this together, we want to keep this all in one place. So that's going to go on top of this section where you see the two lugs there, making sure that this pointed section's upwards. And it's going to pin this wire into place. Now the lugs on here are shaped, so you can only really put it in one way anyway. So I'll get that in. And as you can see, that's over those two lugs there. And it's just a case of pinning both of these sections together. So that the wire is coming down from the base there. Make sure we're not pinching anything. And there we go. That's together just like that. Now before we put that in though, and attach it completely, remember we've got this trim panel here that we're still going to need to put in, and that's just going to go down the top here between these two parts. Whoops, the other way around. Very fiddly. But you get the idea. So now we're ready to start securing all of these sections together. And we're going to do that with WP screws. Well, we're doing that with lots of screws, but we're going to start doing that with a WP screw, which is a very short screw with a flat head. Looks just like that. That's just going to go into the end on this section here. And there you go, that's in. That's going to hold that part in. The next screws for the next two down here are NP screws. So I'm making sure this is all bit together here. So we've got one NP screw just going into this hole here. Make that nice and tight. The next one, just a little bit further along here. Get that one all the way in. Excellent. And then the last one here is going to use an LP screw. A little bit confusing, because three different screws just to put this into place. So an LP screw just into the end here. Perfect. So now that is looking like that. We could just put that to one side because we've got a little bit of panel to put in, which is going to house the gas cap here, or as we say in the UK, a fuel cap. So we've got the base section, which we're going to be putting on here just like this. It can only go in one way. Excellent. And that's going to be held in with an XP screw, but we need to put the cap in as well. That's going to go on top again. This is shaped. It's got a little keyhole pattern. That's going to go into the top, just like that. Get myself an XP screw, which I've got here. And these are really long screws, these ones. So I can just put that down and then tighten this up. Make sure it's tight. There we go. That's the fuel filler cap on. It's not able to come out, but it does look good on the vehicle. We're going to attach this to the wing section that we've just been working on. Now this is going to go over the two holes that we can just see here. So when I put this on, it's going to go on just like that there. That's going to be held in with DM screws. Now these are going into metal, so I am going to put some oil just on my screw to help me out here. And we'll get this screwed in. That's the top one, and here's the bottom one. Once that's in, that looks brilliant. I love it. We can put that to one side. We need a part that we had from the last stage, this lovely great metal part here. We're going to be putting some tabs on this side here, which means I'm going to bring up my Partwork Upgrades mat here. I'll have it this way around so I don't scratch this. Want it this way around. And these are the tabs that I'm going to be putting into place. Now they need to go just over these sections here. So we're going to have one here and one just at the top here. And they're going to be held in with XM screws. Now the XM screws are flange screws. They look like this, going into metal. So I'll just put them in there. These look like cable clips, so I don't know if we're going to be using this to trunk the cables around. Don't know. That's the excitement of the build. We don't know what we're doing. We just come by at every single stage. Okay, and one in this side. So those two clips in like that. Then we're going to be bringing over what we've been working on previously. This is going to be going into the end here. So I'm just lining everything up like that. And we've got three points that this attaches to this section, and they're DM screws. This is a long stage, this one, isn't it? So I'll just put them in loose at the moment just till I get this attached. And here's the third one going in. So that's three screws in. Just make sure these are lovely and tight. So now that looks like that. That looks lovely. And then we've just got the reflector that we worked on previously. We're just going to be putting this in as well. That's just going to go over the point at the end this way round. So it's going to slot in just like that. And that's going to be held in just from this side with IP screws. There is two screw holes in here to attach that, but they're really hard to show you on camera. I don't know if you can see them in there. Put one more in. So that should sit nice and flush on there just like that. That's beautiful. Love that. So I'm just getting myself together here because we're going to have to bring over the massive frame of the vehicle. I've just put some masking tape on that, but I'm going to turn this over. turn the white balance down here, we need these four wires which are coming from this side of the vehicle, which is the right side of the vehicle. You've got the right rear door switch, you've got the illumination, you've got the rear door switch here, and then you've got the lights that are coming from this side here. So we've got all four of these coming through here. And what we want to do is we want to put these, move this out of the way, into the clips that we've got in this plate just here. Now once they're on and they're in, I can actually pull them tight, but let's just get them in first. Then I'm going to line up where this is going onto the vehicle here. Now the first thing we're going to do, we're going to be attaching this with an IM screw just down at this point here. And there we go, that's in. Now I'm just going to tidy these wires up again before I do any more screwing in. I'm going to put an IM screw just in this side over here and screw that tight. Now we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 more IM screws to put in place. So I'm going to do that now, but while I'm doing it, I'm just going to make sure that I've got all of these wires nice and tidy around this section. Now the other thing you want to do is you want to feed these wires underneath these sections over here. So they're not pinched, but they'll keep the wires all in one place. So I've just lifted this section up here to get the wire through, not pinched anymore. So as you can see, the wires are lovely and tidy around this whole section now. So I'm going to put the rest of the IM screws just into this side to hold this into place. Now once they're all in, we're not finished there yet, we need NP screws. And they're just going to go onto the holes along this side just here. So we've got them here. We're going to screw that in like this. That'll just pull the top section in. And there you go. That's all of the NP screws in. We do have this wheel arch left over, but that's all there is to do in that stage. So I'm going to rotate the vehicle around now, because we're going to be fitting the trim panel on this side here. So I will get off all of my masking tape I've got on the side here. Now this is what the first trim panel looks like, and we want to make sure when we put this in, we're not going to bite any of these leads down. Now we're going to secure that in from the other side here. So I'll just gently roll this on its back with VP screws. But when you start it, the very front one doesn't use a VP screws, it uses an AP screw. Let's put this in here. And that's going to start this off. Just want to make sure that these two leads here are coming out the middle, just like that. Get these ones in. And the last one just on this side here. We're going to turn it round and do exactly the same on the other side. Now on the other side, we don't have to worry about any wires, so we can just put this straight over the top. No wires are going to pinch in here. Once again though, we're going to start the first screw with an AP screw and then continue with the other screws as we go along. So when that's finished, we're going to be doing the rear fender and number plate. Now the number plate is die cast, it's metal, and it looks just like that. This is going to be fitted onto this section with BM screws. So I'm going to attach that now, and then we'll bring the whole fender looking like this over to the vehicle. And it just slots into the back with IM screws and JP screws. JP screws down the sides and an IM screw just down the middle there. So I've got the JP screws here. They're just going to go in this side. And there you go. That is that in place. So if I just turn this upside down so you can see what this looks like. There you go. That looks brilliant. Okay, we can actually get rid of this bodywork now. As a matter of fact, I've just put it up there. That looks good, doesn't it? I love the lining at the bottom. That's really boosted that off. I'm going to bring over the internals of the vehicle. We're finally going to fit the steering wheel. So this is what the steering wheel looks like. And we have this arm that they provided in this pack. Now, we did have an arm for that, but obviously they want us to change it now. So I'm just going to take the old one off, or the stalk, and put the new one on. The old one just kept rotating around when we had it on the steering wheel. So hopefully that's going to stop that problem. Once we've got that, we'll fit it over the shaft of the steering column here, making sure it's the right way around. It has got a directional pattern in there. Then we're going to take the steering wheel, again, making sure that's the right way around. And that's just going to fit over the top like this. And that's going to be held in with a DM screw. So I'll get that together here. Screw that all the way in and make sure that's really tight. I'm just holding that together so we can get that in. And as you can see, that turns perfectly so the stalks don't turn at the same time. But finally, we have now got a working steering wheel in the vehicle. Long time coming, that is. I do have to put the cap on, but I'll do that afterwards. But that looks excellent. Right, so I've just put the case back onto the vehicle. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to try and pick it up. It's very heavy. So you can see what this looks like. You ready? I can't lift it. Hang on. Oh, Jesus. There you go. That is what the Ecto-1 is looking like at the moment. And it's really heavy. I've got to put it down. That's one heavy beast of a car. I can't weigh it. There's no way the scales are actually going to register how heavy that is. That is ginormously heavy. It's like a lead weight. But that was not so much fiddly, but because of the weight of the vehicle and how big it is, that's what made it a little bit difficult this stage. But, you know, it's no different to what we did on the other one. We've just got to make sure your wire tidy is bang up to it, because if it's not, it's a good chance that you're going to go through one of your wires. Just make sure that when you put your screws in, you're not trapping any wires under there. But I really do hope you liked that video. If you did, please remember to give me a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed already, please remember to subscribe. Other than that, take care.